And governors just look, work with not very carefully. There also, this health card, so this is a very strategic ambiguity or strategic purchase. Now, how it will unfold, whether it will unfold in a positive direction or negative direction, is something that we have to really guess on, you know.
What would you consider positive and negative?
No, no, the thing is that if you are saying, for me, given the ECA, public-private partnership is, or engaging private sector is going to be a, we can't leave out private sector completely. So we have to give some lip service to private sector. So by just mentioning there is going to be a provision for strategic purchase, but strengthening in the public sector in a significant manner so that there is no need of strategic purchase or minimal need of strategic purchase. So we are not antagonizing private sector to a bigger extent.
Then shouldn't we much more aggressively say, yes, we will do 2.5% because we are going to strengthen this public system and for this we will need this money.
The other way
around, but when you're being so hesitant about saying ki 2.5 pata nahi pahunchenge nahi, so you're not confident of strengthening the public system.
And then how else will you do it if you're not increasing the budget?
If you're not going to get even 2.5%, you're not going to get anywhere in strengthening. You're still going to leave the primacy in the hands of the private sector as it has become today.
So that is one. So how
else will you increase increase hospitals, or, you know, strengthen them? You have to have financing.
I mean, it must be able to state with greater confidence that we will give more money to health sector.
Now
Sundaraman cannot write this, but this as Government of India document, Government of India must write. Otherwise, the rest of it is nonsense. Right? And which is what, when in our paper, we've taken that standard position and said it must increase 5 times in this budget and double it the next time, it becomes 10 times increase, and the logic of it was per capita expenditure required. Right? Now, if they're not ready to do that, then the rest of it means you're giving it to private sector, period.
Then that's why I said this whole health card strategic purchase would reduce. Now, given, because this, either they are giving lip service to private sector or public sector. Now, given the ethos of public sector and the experience of private sector, and that's why I said this public institution of secondary and tertiary level would be reduced to institution which would just govern purchase, strategic purchase for private sector.
No, but they may not actually have, the hospitals may not have the right to do that. It may be the societies. It may be local district health society which does it.
But at the end of this, then...
Or the RKS which will do it. I mean, so RKS is hospital.
Hospitals would basically then...
Yeah, but if you're saying strengthen the human resources there also.
Huh.
So you strengthen human... the ideal situation therefore means is that we are in the process of strengthening HR, equipment, infrastructure, but this need is immediate. So, whatever is available in the private, we will contract in and get an anesthetist. My pass anesthetist nahi hai toh, cesarean karna hai. We'll get the anesthetist and bring it. That's strategic purchase. But over time, I will ensure that either my doctors are multitasked to do anesthesia or that I have an anesthetist in my hospital. Right. Now, that is the logic by which you would say that incrementally public system strengthens and you need, the need for private goes down. But as you're saying, realistically, will that happen? Now, to me, realistically, that will happen in states. This will be varied across states. Right? It's not going to be a national thing. It's going to be varied by what is available in which state. State-wise, it will depend on the political will, obviously, and the capacities of the health, the history of health system development.
Actually.
You know, in Himachal and Odisha, where there is hardly any private sector as of now, this will actually encourage private sector development and move it in that direction. Because you're now saying, we have money for you, come. Right? But you will also have a public system which stands on its own, and most doctors are in the public sector and that's what they are providing. So it is likely that both this will get strengthened and private will also come in partially. But in states like, let's say what, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, public money will start going into private sector straight off. And your private sector public sector will also get commercialized just like your private. That's what this means.
this ambiguity in what constitutes strategic purchase is leaving scope for all kinds of possibilities and imagination.
That's why I left it ambiguous, because if it's so clear, then why
and then we are free to build our own narrative and story how it will unfold. There are two possibilities, either it will strengthen public sector or either it will reduce private sector, public sector only to buy
purchasers.
Now, this, why I am saying the CHCs and district hospitals would be reduced to purchasers, because over a period of time, the quantum, nature...
Like a CGHS here, it only signs and says, refer to so and so,
So, because now CGHS is a very small component, but if it is more, then going and checking private hospital, doing some kind of, whether these services are being given or not, even they are charging, overcharging. These doctors in public sector would go and regulate that much, is what would happen in future, if the strategic purchase is going to happen from the private sector.
रिश्ता बढ़ जाएगा करप्शन का जैसे इंस्पेक्टर
बट हाँ
रेगुलेशन इज अगेन इफ दे नॉट इवन मेंशनिंग द मैकेनिज्म इट्स गोइंग टू बी
So in regulatory framework they are talking about drug control, then
exactly. It's all about
all of that, but not regulation at of institutional level or private sector. What
but ये वो तो है consumer protection act और कहाँ कहीं है ना?
है शायद
और ये clinical establishments act.
वो तो नहीं clinical establishment act is saying there is need for now all the actors to come together and regulate this evolve regulatory framework. So they are saying the IMA is opposition to Clinical Establishment Act and all. So that is mentioned somewhere. So that has to be.
See, now strategic purchasing, supposing it means that okay, the institutions were ready to come into the regulatory framework. Se purchase hoga jo nahi aata, obviously nahi hoga.
So the, already the quality, then this whole quality accreditation is one. And what kind of regulatory framework then for private sector is?
Then the Clinical Establishment Act the state has to do if it wants to do strategic purchasing.
Yeah.
And enforce Clinical Establishment. Those who register under Clinical Establishment Act have therefore to give this information. And thereby it becomes a regulatory mechanism.
The Clinical Establishment Act also is also problematic version. This whole Clinical Establishment Act is not much different from this quality accreditation mechanism. We have so many specialists. Now this Matthew Varghese, who was there. He is from Mission Hospital. They are also saying that we are opposing private hospital. This clinical establishment.
Matthew Varghese was which one? CMAI?
No, he is St. Stephen. Director.
Matthew Varghese.
What he said was, we oppose this clinical establishment act because then, if say for example in some peripheral area, if some couple is going and providing some services, and if you are going to close them down because he doesn't have this thing, so that's these many specialists, because this already so many specialists can't go there. Now, two are going there and are stopping them because rest two are not there is
counterproductive.
And nature of private sector, now this whole the accreditation norms, the way they are developed are for multi-speciality hospitals, kind of CHC is small level, PSC is just one doctor or two doctors. CSC is a model around which they are saying that these many specialists are needed and that's how hospital should be. But there are no mechanisms how a ENT hospital run by one ENT specialist should be. There is no mechanism to say ki how a hospital run by just a gynecologist and pediatrician should be. And if you look at a private sector, it has all kinds of permutation combination depending on husband, who is wife, and who are their relatives, and who are their caste members, and that's how hospitals come in. And it is very difficult to develop those quality standards also.
But the Clinical Establishment Act, how much of it like really, does it really govern these own account establishments? No.
It makes provision for clinical
registration.
Only registration is what is needed.
Registration, and what they anticipate is that incrementally they will increase the information that they will ask the registered institutions to give.
Yes.
Right. So initially it is only ki hum ye hain, hamare itne staff hai, and hum ye services provide. That's all.
then you start asking how many patients, then you add on, you will add on in future. Abhi to you have to break this mindset of the private sector not to be regulated. So it was seen as a minimal thing of only
registration.
But now they are building all these things that you are saying.
So there was a provision in the Clinical Establishment Act to develop standard treatment guidelines, to develop what constitutes norms for these hospitals at different levels. So, and there has to be bodies for each of these. At state level, district magistrate would be the key person who with whom they would be registered, and they would have statutory powers to go and do accidental checkups or annual checkup of these institutions, and was recommended it to the establishment act. But that much was there, not beyond registration and periodic registration and provision for checkups of these institutions. And norms and standard treatment guidelines to be developed.
And this is all proviso to the states adopting it or not adopting it.
Four states had asked for it, and that's how it was developed. Nine states.
That's a constitutional thing. Uh-huh. That the center develops a law only if three or four states ask for it. That's national central legislation. But then it has to be adopted by different states for it to be applicable in their areas. So they can change it, they can modify it. And so,
by when do you have to send this feedback?
By the 28th.
Can I write something and send it to you?
Yeah. So this is one set of issues we can see of provisioning and access issues and how they are going to come and the costing and finance. Politics of money. There's some sense of politics of money.
Very little, because I was looking at the document more. So that's why I thought it would be too sensitive. But I mean, some things they are acknowledging that, you know, it's not just about the number of people you are training and sending out, that there is a lack of a rural orientation, for instance, is very clear. And within the section on human resources, they do talk about the need for some pedagogic intervention in that, but exactly how, what is not very clear at all. So if you come to page 37.
11 says this, but it has little orientation to rural service, any public services.
Yeah.
And the teaching standards are very varied, some optimal skill sets requiring extensive in-service training subsequently. Guide expansion to provide. This is where the need is. Okay. Then, which page are you saying?
So, 37 if we go to. Then, it is important that you have a workforce where, you know, you pick the most appropriate person in terms of skills and motivation for the right job in the right place. If you go to 37, first two lines. So there is that kind of recognition. And also the degree of irrational care that is happening because of the tendency of most of the people to go to.
Go to NHP plus whatever notes come, etc. will circulate, so you also can go through it and you can add your points.
ID.
So then I shall forward that mail with CC to Nani so that it will be on the Tel Swaraj group also.
And then if you see 5.4, there is in terms of increasing a rural orientation, page 37 only, they say that the most effective or various possible approaches, the positive preference for students from underserviced areas, location of medical colleges in rural areas, and a curriculum and pedagogy which gives exposure and motivation to work with communities. And also a recognition that measures of compulsion have a limited value. I mean, they might be useful, but unless and until other things are applied to it, nothing much is going to come out of that. And there is a recognition also of the need for increasing the importance of a general health practitioner, because general practice is being undermined because of the emphasis on specialists and how the skills of a general practitioner might be upgraded through various other kinds of like distance learning programs and things like that. But I'd like to sort of look at it a little more carefully, ma'am, and write in tomorrow instead of making things in mind in the morning.
So they're saying rural orientation of the doctors and preference for rural students for becoming a doctor, but then on other side they recommend all India entrance exam for medical education. Mm. They become difficult to
do
that.
Also, I mean, like, if is it just an exposure to communities that is going to change, like motivation, community related work that is going to change motivation? I do not know. It's also about a reorientation of the curriculum and the philosophy underlying it also.
That they are mentioning.
They are mentioning it. Where is it?
The same section, no?
They are saying, but when they say pedagogy, then they are basically saying with a greater exposure to work with communities. That's what I saw, and I could be wrong because I have to read.
Page 37, last paragraph.
Last the पहले वाले में है actually. उसी last paragraph में बीच के जो दो तीन लाइन है उसमें another positive determinant of voluntary rural location of doctors is a more rural location of medical colleges and a curriculum and pedagogy of medical education which provides exposure and motivation to work with communities.
Equally important is to create positive practice environment where professionals can stay in touch with peers, upgrade their skills and positive social environment through better housing, more flexible terms of employment, active measures to community support. Incentive, financial and monetary would also be used, and where there is a substantial, they would make big difference. Measures of compulsion, whether though mandatory, loser posting or mandatory rotational postings are valuable strategies, but these posting in the context where the other strategies are also applied. So, the same exact packages for policy measures that would successfully address the problem doctor vacancy would vary from state to state and would change over time. Let's start talking about certification program for ASHAs, where some of ASHAs can become ANMs. So that was a good development in my opinion. So they don't talk about public health care. They talk about
management.
Public health care.
Which page is that?
beginning of the document?
One for page 10. You know what you're saying about this, no? I mean, public private, you got this point, which is what? Point 2.1 to health, that healthcare industry business. Mm-hmm. While recognizing that the growth of such industry brings in revenue through medical tourism and that it provides employment, there is a necessity and a rationale for the health ministry to intervene and to actively shape the growth of this sector for ensuring that it is aligned to its overall health policy goals, especially with regards to access and financial protection. There is also a need to ensure that excessive capitalization and overcrowding in a few cities does not lead to demands on public financing, and that the basic policy structure, especially as regards cost, standards and regulation, is not unduly influenced by the requirements and perceptions of industry. So then what does it propose for that?
Do you then expect them, as a policy document, give the programs for implementing what their objective is? So, because as a policy document, they can't go into details. But even this, the outcome of it can be, don't allow overgrowth of private sector in urban areas, and they are saying somewhere down the line, competition is leading to irrational practices. This is what I'm calling a sheepish way of making space for regulation of private sector.
But the other way, for example, which has always been done in other sectors, is you give incentives for setting up in rural areas. If you want the private sector as a provider there, mm-hmm. but you don't actually are not even saying that. Mm-hmm. Because private sector is, because it's there, you use it as today. You're not saying that you're going to encourage private sector growth.
The private sector in rural areas and those areas which is underserved, they are saying provide appropriate skill to meet public health code, mm-hmm. opportunities for skill upgradation to serve community better, participation in disease notification and surveillance effort. So this section is saying not incentive, because in other section is saying growth of private health industry has been active effort by giving them tax exemptions, giving them less loans or less interest rates, giving them import subsidies. So that is applicable for all. For establishing in rural hospital also, there is a tax exemption for first 10 years or something. So that provision is already there for...
In some states or others. This is the can't be a central thing. Except for import and for equipment, etc.
But tax exemption and interest rates which are more favorable are already there for rural hospitals, and here in the last page number 43, first two paragraphs are about how this private sector should be engaged.
Their regulation is argued for much more specific things. 7.22.
it's into evolving a regulatory framework.
Yeah. So then making space for regulation of private sector wherever that is possible, but yes, saying upfront would be completely rejected given the experience that regulation of private sector, Montexi would red line say, why are you doing this?
Yeah, but point is this is not Montexi.
Now it's a movie.
So what is so? No, but this is which is, it is a regime which is...
Change.
No, monitor and catch. That's their framework.
But what was anticipated from what I can say after Modi government coming in, there is more self-censorship that is happening and that is more unfortunate. So we don't have any expectations. So what we are asking for from this new government is also going to be very small.
Exactly.
This self-regulation or self-censorship shouldn't happen. State is going to censor you in many ways, but state is going to censor us, so we start self-censoring ourselves. And that's why I'm saying this sheepishness in regulation of private sector. So this self-censorship is what I'm...
Yeah, but the point is, this is the government's, this is Modi's document. This is not Sundaraman document. This is out in the public domain as a Modi document.
Yeah. So then,
so can Modi go get away with this? No.
No. Then
we have to not see it as a Sundaraman document. Yeah. Mm. We have to see it as a Modi government, NADA's document.
Yeah, if you
NADA ministry document.
Can this strong prime minister not use his clout and regulate private sector? And if there is such a way,
we bring in mechanisms for regulation of private sector.
And if it cannot be done by Modi, nobody can do it. We should push it like this. Such a strong prime minister.
And at the same time saying, no, use it first to see that your own systems function better. Yeah. Only then can you say anything to the private sector. I mean, your own don't function and you start catching them, won't do.
Yeah.
But your functioning means you have to give them message. Yeah? If he gives the message that he cuts down on budget, now what is the message you're giving? Who's going to give any importance to health sector? So it is first to realize that this is an onus on the top for which this document could have been used by even Sundaram.
True.
Which it has not been done. It has only tried to fall in line with.
Self-censorship is what is...
You're saying that Sundaraman could have worded, could have taken a more sort of active stand on trying to push through the whole thing of regulation and also making a call for the public. He's not saying that. He's the scribe. Which is stating this policy. Right. Now supposing it was to say, we are going to ensure that public systems are further strengthened by injecting in more funds. This is the minimum quantum that we will have to inject. Right. Which now it should, if NADA's thing goes through, and NADA's quite powerful. If it, the 50,000 goes through, yeah, in the next, so for the 5 years if that happens, it should get stated in the policy. Mm-hmm. Right, this is what, and we are going to reach our target of 2.5.
Yeah.
Right,
and with that 2.5, how will we spend that 2.5? We have spent it on ensuring drugs, diagnostics, regularization of staff.
Yeah.
And I mean, if you look at, I have been wanting to do that, I have not yet done it. The AAP manifesto for Delhi. Compare that and compare this.
Yeah, I was going to talk to you about this. Now, this new thing coming in, this AAP government is being there, and urban health services being in such a situation. Now, there is some space for thinking about what can be done about urban health services in Delhi, given new government which you think can have some intervention. So, what is it that we want and how it can be done in the way? We want it for private, at least urban sector. And this if it happens in
Delhi. They read the manifesto?
No, completely.
They have a 70 point program, which is 70 points of the manifesto given bullet points. Mm-hmm. And then there's a detail of each of them in a manifesto. Mm-hmm. I think we should read it. An important one. For health, it's short. There's much more. Water is 5 pages. Electricity, these are to their
major chunks and governance mechanisms, Swaraj and Mohalla Sabhas and all that. But health wale ke, there are